All right, well, this weekend, Burt's Warehouse in Eastern Market is preparing for a comedic performance for everyone to enjoy. You may remember comedian and actor Mark Curry from ABC's hit sitcom Hanging with Mr. Cooper. Well, we're fortunate enough to be joined by Mark Curry this morning. He's going to be telling us all about what's coming up this weekend. Mark, thank you so much for joining us.
Good morning. I'm sorry. No, good morning. How you doing?
I'm fantastic. You know, you hanging with Mr. Cooper, that was what, that was in the early 90s. You've been in this game for a minute. Tell us a little bit about
87. I've been in this game since 1987, man. I've been in this game so long. Look, the first person I opened up for was Ray Charles. That's how old I am. Ray Charles, yes.
How'd you get your start?
I got my start being a little boy in Oakland, California. Wanted to get out the ghetto, wanted to be funny, idolized Richard Pryor, went to a Richard Pryor concert, and the rest was history.
Well, and you all clearly had the talent. Were you just a funny kid before you saw Richard Pryor? I mean, was that just your nature?
Yes, I was a funny kid. I was growing up, I was always funny. I used funny as a mechanism because I was so skinny. And so I didn't get beat up by using my funny. And that's a true story. Guys were about to beat me up. I would say something funny and give them a second, give me a chance to run. I was a fast runner. So I'd tell them a joke, and they'd be like, what did he say? And by the time that, I'm two blocks down, waving.
So either you were going to be a comedian or a track star.
Exactly, both.
All right. Well, you're going to be in town this weekend performing alongside Detroiters Mike Bonner and Foolish. Tell us a little bit about what the audience can expect at Burt's Warehouse this weekend.
Well, I want them to expect to be able to laugh. That's what it's all about, to laugh, to look at, you know, things in life and just laugh and have fun. You know, for 1 hour, I'm going to make them laugh for a pure hour, and that's it. I'm not trying to preach. I'm not trying to put a message in. I'm just trying to be crazy as possible and be funny, funny, funny. That's all I'm trying to do.
Yeah, and look, after this year, the past 12 months, we can all use a laugh.
Yes.
How have your performances been impacted by COVID? If they have, I mean, has it changed your comedy, changed your insight?
It changed my life because here, you know, suddenly my job stopped. So your job kept going, but my job just stopped, you know. And so they had me take a chance to look at comedy and had me write more. That's what I did. I just write more jokes and just to be funny. And it impacted me because I miss comedy and I want to do a special. So I'm doing all this just to do a special. I figure, you know, life isn't promised. Let me do one last special and get it all out. So it's time. That's what I'm working on now, and that's why I'm on the road. And plus, I want to be on the road because I got people in my house. I got family in my house. So when you got family in the house, I'm trying to leave. I found a pot in the bottom of my pool. How did a pot get the bottom of my pool? But so I got family in my house. I'm ready to get out the house.
When you're in Detroit, you ain't got to worry about that. Let them do what they're doing out there, and you'll be here. How would you describe your comedy?
My comedy is just being fun. I like to talk about people. I like to, you know, and just have some fun with it. I try not to hurt anybody. And I try not to do anything political. I'm not going down that road. My goal is just to make you laugh. And I try to write differently from everybody else because there's so many comedians out there writing on the same subject. So I try to take a different approach to anything. And just try to take the positive or the negative and just try to turn it around and just try to be creative with it. So people see that, say, that was a creative joke. We like that.
All right. And look, you said you got your start in 1987. What's behind your longevity? There are lots of people who are flashes in the pan. They come and they go. But you've been around for decades.
That's a good question. I don't know. You know, I think just staying in relative, you know, keeping information, like listening to you and listening to the news and deciphering things and don't stay on one subject and just bounce subjects. And I never really trend. I don't like to do trending subjects because they go away. I like to write subjects that stay for a long time. And that's what I like to do. I just try to keep writing and just try to stay up with the young people, basically. You got to stay on Twitter, man. You got to stay on TikTok. You got to know how to dance on TikTok. You got to know how to do it. See, kids right now, you know, they ain't got no skills. If the internet go out, they go out. That's just the way it is. Mm-hmm. You know, back in the day, we didn't have the internet. Your mama used to leave you in the car for 5 hours. And you had to use your imagination. Kids don't have imagination because it's in their hand. We had to have imagination because our toys didn't have no batteries. So we had to make sounds with a hot wheel.
Yeah.
And make sounds. And so these are the things that I talk about growing up, you know, just growing up things we had. We didn't have no water growing up. He had need water. I need water.
I can't wait to see you. Hose. I can't wait to see you coming up this weekend at Burt's Theater on Russell Street and Eastern Market. You're going to be there Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Go to funnydetroit.com if you want to see Mark Curry, legendary funny man, been around for decades, still doing it big time. Thank you, Mark, for joining us.
Thank you. I love you, man.
Thanks. Have a great weekend.
Peace.